The James Webb Space Telescope has changed the way cosmologists see the solar system as a whole. This wonderful innovation is the largest optical telescope in space, and was primarily designed to see and analyze astronomical objects in space using infrared light. While the JWST was exploring the Milky Way galaxy, scientists were shocked to find a huge structure that left them speechless. What is this big structure? How will it change the way we study the universe? What will the next steps be for scientists after they find it? Want to know more about it? Don't worry, the future space got your back, so let's get started. Space technology such as the JWST has allowed humanity to make significant strides in its exploration of the cosmos, and this trend shows no signs of slowing down. Join us as we look at the huge structure found at the center of the Milky Way by the James Webb Space Telescope, which used to be called the Next Generation Space Telescope. One of NASA's best ideas is the JWST. In September 2002, the billion-dollar telescope was renamed after James E. Webb, who was in charge of NASA during the Mercury, Apollo, and Gemini programs from 1961 to 68. The design of the space telescope was also led and developed by two large agencies, the Canadian Space Agency and the European Space Agency. Each agency played a different role in the development and operation of James Webb technology, which will be launched on December 25, 2021, on an Arian 5 rocket provided by the European Space Agency. Northrop Grumman was the main contractor for the JWST. It was sent into space from the European Spaceport in French Guiana, which is on the southeastern coast of South America. At the same time, the NASA Goddard Space Flight Center GSFC in Maryland oversaw the development of the telescope, and the Space Telescope Science Institute on the Homewood campus of Johns Hopkins University in Baltimore is in charge of running the powerful space telescope. This big infrared telescope has a primary mirror made of 18 hexagonal pieces of gold-plated beryllium. Together, they make a 6.5-meter diameter mirror, which is bigger than Hubble's 2.4-meter diameter mirror. Compared to the Hubble, the JWST works and looks at a lower frequency range, from long-wavelength visible red light to mid-infrared 0.6 to 28.3 micrometers, while the Hubble works and looks at near-ultraviolet and visible 0.12 to 0.8 micrometers. It means that the JWST needs to be kept at a temperature between minus 223 degrees Celsius and minus 370 degrees Fahrenheit to keep working. This is so that the infrared light from the telescope doesn't get in the way of the light that is being collected. This amazing invention is in a solar orbit close to the Sun at Earth's L2 Lagrange point, about 1.5 million kilometers from the Earth. Its five-layer sun shield keeps it from getting too hot from the Earth's moon and sun. According to the successful deployment of all parts of the Webb Space Telescope is a historic event. The mission crew took a major leap a few weeks later on January 24, 2022, when they fired Webb's thrusters and sent the space telescope into orbit around the Sun at the second Lagrange point, its ultimate destination, about a million miles from Earth. Congratulations to the team for all the hard work they did to make sure Webb got to L2 safely. Today, we're one step closer to finding out what's going on in the universe, and I can't wait until this summer to see Webb's first new views of the universe. The JWST is in a place that gives it a perfect and wide view of the universe and keeps its scientific instruments in optics in a steady state. This wonderful invention would have to be cold enough for it to work and do standard science like it was made to do. On its first mission, this space technology also broke a record when U.S. Vice President Joe Biden saw the first full-color image from the Webb, the sharpest and most detailed infrared picture ever taken of the faraway universe. It is called the first deep field of the space telescope. The picture shows galaxy cluster SMK0723, which is full of thousands of galaxies. The next day, on July 12, 2022, the farthest and faintest objects ever seen in the infrared will be added to the cluster. More pictures taken by Webb's cutting-edge scientific equipment were made public to show how well it works, which included the Southern Ring Nebula WASP-96b spectrum and Stefan's Group of Five and the Carina Nebula. With recent discoveries, a new story about how the universe began has come to life. Thousands of young stars that had never been seen before were found in a stellar nursery, and 30 Dorados were caught with the right tools for the job. The Tarantula Nebula is what NASA's James Webb Space Telescope called these young stars. In the previous telescope pictures, you could see the dusty filaments of the nebula. This is because the nebula has been a favorite place to study star formation for a very long time. The JWST also showed more background galaxies in the far distance, such as how the gas and dust in the nebulas are made and how they are arranged to support the young stars. The Tarantula Nebula is the brightest and biggest star-forming area in the group of galaxies close to our Milky Way. It is 161,000 light-years away in the large Magellanic Cloud Galaxy. It is where the biggest and hottest stars in the universe live. Because of this, astronomers used three high-resolution infrared instruments on the JWST to look at the tarantula. When seen through the near-infrared camera on the space telescope, the area looks like a hibernating tarantula's home with its silk all lined up. When you look at the near-cam image, you will see that the intense radiation from a cluster of huge young stars that shine pale blue has cut a hole in the nebula. When shorter wavelengths of light are absorbed or scattered by dust grains in the nebula, points of light show that embedded protostars are gaining mass. As longer mid-infrared wavelengths get through the dust, the web disappears, revealing a part of the universe that had never been seen before. Astronomers are very interested in the Tarantula Nebula because it has a similar type of chemical material. This chemical matter is the same as the huge areas where stars are being made that were seen on the cosmic moon when the universe was only a few billion years old. The way stars were made was at its best. Our galaxy's star-forming regions do not make stars at the same alarming rate as the Tarantula Nebula does because they are not made of the same chemicals. Because it is so different, the Tarantula Nebula is a great example of what is going on in the universe as it gets closer to its brightest noon. Astronomers would be able to watch and compare observations of star formation in the Tarantula Nebula with the Webb Space Telescope. They would be able to do this by making detailed observations of faraway galaxies at cosmic noon. The JWST has already begun to reveal things about the universe that have never been seen before. The brilliant invention is just getting started on his mission to change the story and history of stellar creation. Even though people have made a lot of effort and spent a long time looking at the stars, there are still a lot of mysteries about how stars are made. This is because the incredibly thick cloud of star nurseries prevents us from seeing clear and detailed photos of what has been going on in that area. The JWST is here to put on a show, since it has the largest optical telescope in the universe. As it gradually reveals the secrets of the cosmos, all we need to do is kick back, take it easy, and absorb the information. Let us know what you think about it in the section below. That's all for today. Hope you all liked our video, so don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see more of our incredible videos. Look forward to seeing you in the next video.